We all have the same 24 hours in a day, but isn't it interesting how certain people are able to create massive success and wealth while others end up having an average normal life? Now, without counting those who grew up wealthy or were lucky to inherit or win the lottery, we have to admit that there has been many people who came from nothing and built massive levels of success and wealth with those same 24 hours a day. So today we are looking at how the rich leverage their time and are able to make more money by working less. If you like videos about business, money, and psychology, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell button to not miss any of our value-packed videos. And let's get started. Now, when I say working less, I don't mean that these people don't work hard to build their wealth. On the contrary, they work incredibly hard, especially at the beginning of their journey to create the life they have now. What I mean is how they use their time to accomplish more in less time than the average person. How they use their 24 hours compared to 99% of the population, and how they build their wealth over time so eventually they don't have to work if they don't want to. The first thing, and something that is becoming increasingly important when it comes to getting started on your journey to wealth, is understanding the difference between absolute income and relative income. Absolute income focuses only on the absolute number of dollars earned, while relative income focuses on time, location, mobility, and even the lifestyle of the individual. For example, let's say that my friend Tom here makes $100,000 a year, and my friend Jerry makes $80,000 a year. In absolute income, Tom is richer than Jerry, because absolute income only focuses on the dollar amount. But let's dive a little further. What if Tom has to work 80 hours a week in order to make his $100,000, while Jerry only has to work 30 hours per week to make his $80,000? This means that Tom makes $26 per hour, while Jerry makes over $55 per hour of his work. In income relative to time, Jerry is richer. Now let's go even deeper. Tom has to stay in New York City, which is a fairly expensive city to live in, all because his job is there. Jerry, on the other hand, can live anywhere he wants to. While Tom has to pay $6,000 per month just for living expenses in New York City, Jerry spends $2,500 a month to live in a nice place in beautiful Thailand. This means that Jerry ends up with more money at the end of the month than Tom does. Even though Tom makes more money than Jerry, he ends up with less money, less time, and less freedom than Jerry does. Leveraging not only your time but your skills to increase your time value will give you a better opportunity to build wealth, since it can provide you with more time, freedom, and money. A great way we can do this is to focus on developing skills that are valuable to the marketplace. Whether it's learning how to build, market, or sell to audiences online, managing automation systems, or learning copywriting. Building those high dollar skills where you can charge much more money than any normal job can pay you, you will be able to earn more in less time. The reason why building high dollar skills is important is that it allows you to build a strong income that gives you freedom of time. This allows you to focus on scalability or building other additional sources of income. And when it gives you freedom of location, you can still have a great lifestyle while spending much less money. A little secret that virtually all wealthy people follow to make more impact with their time is to focus their time not on tasks, but on scalability. In other words, they avoid being the bottleneck of their business. For example, let's say that you have a hot dog stand. You go and buy the ingredients, you make the food, and you sell the food. And you have a pretty successful small business. You sell out every time, and you have so much demand that some people don't even get to enjoy your delicious hot dogs. Since you do everything, you are the bottleneck of your business. Nothing else will get done unless you take time to do it. But what if you hire employees to take care of these tasks? You have somebody who cooks, somebody who takes care of the customer, and you get a service that will deliver ingredients in case you start running out. All of a sudden, you have a system of business that no longer needs you. You are no longer the bottleneck of the business, and now you can open up as many hot dog stands as you want as long as they are profitable. You are able to make a higher impact, serve more people, and make more money in the process because you focused on scalability instead of just tasks. Think about McDonald's and many of these fast food restaurants. These businesses have systems in place where they are able to hire almost anyone to take care of the tasks while the high-level executives focus on the high-value work, like marketing and advertising. This is why most CEOs and company owners make much more money than the average worker, even when they work fewer hours than their employees. In a way, they fire themselves from the lower value position to focus on the higher value work. A good idea to begin focusing on high value work is to use the 80-20 principle to learn which 20% of your to-do list is going to provide 80% of your results. This is a very powerful strategy if you don't know what tasks you should focus on. The second part of building massive wealth is understanding the financial patterns of the average person versus the wealthy. Learning what assets and liabilities are will allow you to make better decisions with your money. If you're not familiar with these terms, assets are things that put money in your pocket. Liabilities take money out of your pocket. For example, Tom here, like everyone else, has an income and has expenses. And he has a little bit of extra money at the end of the month. So he uses it to go out to the movies every week and buys himself a nicer car, which is a liability because it takes money out of his bank account every month. And so Tom ends up with little to no money at the end of the month. On the other hand, Jerry makes the same amount of money as Tom, but instead of spending his extra cash on going out and getting a nicer car, he saves his money to buy a real estate property so he can rent it out to other people. Now, this asset produces more income for Jerry every single month. Jerry now has a higher income. Jerry uses the extra income to save and invest on more properties, which continue to increase Jerry's income. In a few years, Tom will stay in the same place just with a few nice toys, while Jerry has created multiple streams of income feeding his pocket. The difference between the average person, even if they have a good income, and the wealthy is that the rich use their money and extra time to build assets that create recurring cash flow completely independent of what they do. In other words, these assets produce passive income. As Warren Buffett once said, if you don't learn how to make money while you're asleep, you will work until you die. So first, we must focus on relative income to increase the dollar value over time to make more money in less hours worked. Then we focus on not becoming the bottleneck of this business so it can work without us. Then we invest this money and extra time in assets that create continuous cash flow independent of what you do. This way, no matter what you do, you will still have strong sources of income. These powerful ideas come from two of my favorite financial books, which are The 4-Hour Workweek and Rich Dad Poor Dad, which I highly recommend. In the comments below, let me know what was one concept you took away from this video. And I will see you in the next video.